Peter Pomerantsev, you've written this book, Nothing is True and Everything is Possible, The Surreal Heart of the New Russia. You wrote and you said that the reality shows in Russia are very much based on very successful British and American models. But some fail. The Apprentice failed in Russia.
Yeah, no, it's funny because the idea, yeah, this is why people like me were brought over. We knew the secret formula for success. And obviously the first thing that we all tried was to remake the most successful formats. And The Apprentice is incredibly successful everywhere it goes around the world. There's a British version, American version. Made it in Russia. Found a top oligarch, like third richest man in Russia, to be the star, like the Donald Trump character. Great production values, great storytelling, great cast. Flop. Because nobody in Russia believes that this is how you do business. Business in Russia is built around sort of corruption and backhanded deals. You don't sort of make it by sort of, you know, being a really, really bright, brilliant business mind. If you're a bright, brilliant business mind, you end up in jail or you get exiled, or you have your business taken away. So it completely kind of didn't work in that society. The values didn't match up. However, shows like Survivor did really, really well. I think in Russia there's like a tradition of being humiliated by the weather and the state. You know, it's the country of the gulag. So a show that was all about taking people and like putting them in a really tough situation, really, really well. So it was very interesting what worked and what didn't.
But you said at one point when you were working reality shows, you realized they wanted them scripted.
So they're more, yes, this is something that...
I mean, the authorities did.
Well, the authorities of the channel wanted them scripted. I mean, there's a culture that everything is scripted in Russia. The whole of sort of politics is a scripted reality show where the politicians are told what to do and what role they're meant to perform. And that kind of sense of sort of like desire not to let go was also evident in the way sort of senior channel heads would do reality shows. They expected them to be pretty much scripted out and you'd pretty much tell people what to do. Not all of them, but 98% were like that, which was very hard for us because we were like, no, you've got to be... You know, it's like a mini example of how Russia doesn't believe in democracy. We're like, well, you know, you've just got let the characters be themselves and see where it goes. They're like, what? Be themselves? No. We have to. That doesn't exist. We have to script it from behind the scenes.
And so the Russian public was right not to believe much of these shows.
Yep, completely. I think so. Yeah. But they're in on the game in many ways. They know it's scripted, and they kind of like, you know, they don't judge it on that. They judge it on whether it's good and whether it's fun and emotional. Exactly the same with the politics. So the Russian public completely understands that the politics is fixed. So the point of the politics is that it's entertaining enough when it's fixed, and the Russian Duma, the Russian Parliament, the Russian Senate, it's hilarious. I mean, it's great entertainment. And the politicians talk about it openly as entertainment to distract, you know, create nice storylines for society and so on and so forth. But also there's a menace there as well, because by saying that we can organize society any way we like, we have complete control over all politicians, over all TV, it's sort of a message to society saying, don't mess with us. We have everything under control. So there's also a very subtle sort of pressure being put on people. Same thing with voting and the elections. Everyone knows the elections are rigged. Everyone knows they're a farce. But it's sort of a message. We can, any number we like, we'll create it. Don't mess with us. So that's one of the more subtle games that the Kremlin plays with this population.
Peter Pomerantsev, thank you.